My name's Matt O'Connor. I'm the founder of Fathers4Justice. I'm in a taxi with some of my entourage here today. Brother David's long-standing veteran campaigner, Richard Castle. And I'm on the way to the Royal Courts of Justice because the Z-list celebrity, Chantelle Houghton, is trying to commit me to prison for allegedly breaching a gagging order in relation to a case with another celebrity, Alex Reid, who's also facing committal to prison. We're in the High Court, Royal Courts of Justice, in front of Mr. Justice Hayden. We will not be silenced. We will not be bullied from exposing extreme cases of parental alienation involving public figures who hide behind reporting restriction orders and gagging orders, which are designed not to protect the best interests of the children, but to protect that celebrity from embarrassment. Celebrities who pimp their children out in the media every day for profit. So we have a public and moral duty to expose cases of child abuse, which is what this is. It involves a newly recognised condition, recognised by the World Health Organization, which is called parental alienation. It's in the public interest. It's about open justice. We don't want to live under a North Korean style secret justice system. So that's our mission today. It's going to be interesting. You know, we're here really to sort of not only defend this committal application, trying to send me to prison, trying to send Alex Reid to prison, but also expose the fact that celebrity mothers like Chantelle Houghton hide behind gagging orders that are used really to protect their reputations, to save them from embarrassment. It's nothing to do with the child's best interest. But we're here to campaign for open justice. We're here to defy this attempt to silence me, to silence Fathers4Justice, to stop our campaigning on issues, to stop us campaigning for equal rights for dads, to stop us campaigning on matters like parental alienation, to stop us campaigning on matters of open justice, which are fundamental. If we live in a so-called modern progressive democracy, then we must have open, transparent and accountable family courts, not this North Korean style secrecy which these people try and impose on me.
You can't tell whether or not justice has been done because they won't allow you to see it. No. They won't allow you to report it. Nothing. If Matt gets jailed today, which is a possibility, they might not allow it to be reported. It's been jailed. It's a possibility, which is disgusting. You know, democracy dies in darkness, doesn't it?
What also is shocking as well is that any court orders that are made for the outcome of the children, no records are kept of outcomes of those orders or what happens to the child after those orders were made, which is absolutely ridiculous. So how can anyone consciously say that the courts are acting in the best interest of the child when there's no tangible proof of this?
All we're doing is just highlighting the fact that there are children in this country, 3 million kids living in fatherless homes, that 200 kids every day lose contact with their fathers in these fucking courts. And it's a disgrace. It's an abomination. It's unconscionable that we live in an age where we just gender cleanse families of fathers. And the fact that people are trying to silence me makes me even more determined to do what I do, to carry on the vital work that we do, to expose injustice, and to ensure that at some point we deliver on the promise that we made people, which is deliver 50-50 shared parenting, not just for the benefit of the dads, but to give our children the best of both their parents. And the benefit of 50-50 shared parenting, it frees mothers up so they can go to work, they can start businesses, they can pursue their careers. It allows grandparents, paternal grandparents, to get involved in childcare, thereby saving more money. 50-50 shared parenting would end 90% of court cases overnight. And the other point is better outcomes for our children. Better outcomes for families, better outcomes for our country, reducing the burden on the taxpayer.
Okay. So, my name's Paul Robinson, I'm from Portsmouth, and I've just come out of the Royal Courts of Justice with Matt O'Connor and Reid, the cage fighter chap, who've been acquitted, or basically the judge has just thrown their case out, was brought against them.
For those who don't know, I have just been in the High Court. We're in a wine bar up the road with the Fathers4Justice team. And it was a bit nervy, and I might have been a bit jovial, but it's a scary time.
This is the impeccable Dr. Pellin. This is our legal Yoda, the Yoda of Fathers4Justice, with an encyclopedic knowledge of family law, open justice campaigner, a man we've won many, many victories.
And committal proceedings.
And committal proceedings. Now, didn't have to say much, did you? Because the judge was very irritated by...
The judge did it all for us.
He did. He was, yeah.
I just want to... I'm not going to talk much more because I just want to raise our glass to everyone and say, as William Wallace would say, freedom!
Cheers, mate.
Cheers, mate.
Cheers, guys. Thank you.